Sfilms165, tips, tricks, and techniques. Let's get to it. The History of the Camera, Part 1. I'm Dan Milliken. Cameras were created in the 19th century by utilizing glass to focus light onto a chemically treated surface. As technology improved, glass got better and the chemically treated surfaces were improved. By the early 20th century, the cameras had become somewhat standardized. Then motion picture cameras came along. Same principle, but instead of taking one frame or picture, now an apparatus was created to speed the chemically treated surface, the film, through the housing, enabling the taking of many pictures each second. This was started first by hand cranking the film through, resulting in variable speed. Notice those old movies, all the action is sped up and weird feeling. But motors were eventually added, which led to a standard of 24 frames per second. Each image was exposed in its entirety, creating a progressive order in the images. And these cameras were all mechanical. Then television was invented. And now images were created electronically and not mechanically. Since the United States was leading the world in new technology of television, a group of bureaucrats and engineers sat down, actually mandated by the FCC, to create standards so that everyone who bought a TV could see the same programming. Up to this point, you had RCA making television signals with 400 or so scan lines, and Philco making theirs with 600 scan lines across. The signals weren't compatible, so the government had to step in. This group called themselves the National Television Systems Committee. In 1941, this group, with the acronym NTSC, created the television standard of 525 scan lines at 30 frames per second. An important note, the television would draw the odd lines by skipping every other one on its way down to the bottom and then go up and fill in every other line. It would do this every second, so each pass was called a field. So this procedure is referred to as interlace. When color was brought into the industry in the 50s, the NTSC mandated that it must be compatible with everyone's black and white set. So the three signals of info that created a color picture had to be composited into one signal. Thus, composite was born. Meanwhile, the rest of the world took what the USA had done and improved on it. The PAL standard was created much closer to the film rate and had 25 frames per second. The scan lines were an improved 625 lines across. And when color came around, PAL redid it to keep the three color signals separate or component. And this was the way it stayed for decades. Watch Camera History Part 2 for more.